Bukstein name came about when my father, who lived in the Ukraine, in a little town called Imelchinov, his name was Oscar Bookchin. But when he came to this country and he went through Ellis Island, the immigration officials couldn't quite understand it, so they wrote down Bukstein, B-U-K-S-T-E-I-N. He came and there he was in New York. His sweetheart, his young sweetheart, Rose Gostman, she was 16 years old, and she followed him. Well, he was a pretty good entrepreneur, and he soon had the largest factory in St. Louis, over 300 employees. He made pants, men's trousers. I came to work for him in 1951. The main thing is I just got a chance to see him in action with the people in the factory, how they liked him and how he related to him. He could get along with everybody.
At Christmas time, my father-in-law had these parties every year, a big dinner and presents for the poor children in town. And then also the schools were given a movie and a present and candy and all that sort of thing. And he was the Santa Claus. And someone says, how come he speaks with so funny? He had a little Russian accent. He did very well at it and he liked it. He loved the kids.
He was very gregarious and got along with people. It was a natural thing for him to get along, for example, in politics. He had the opportunity to meet and become friends with Harry Truman. He was instrumental in helping two governors become elected. And when they became elected, they made him a colonel, an honorary colonel. But for Truman's inauguration, he was invited to attend.
I, Harry S. Truman, do solemnly swear that I will faithfully execute the office of President of the United States.
He had a great time. He met a lot of people besides Truman. And one of the politicians said, I want you to meet somebody. And he got a great thrill because the person they took him to meet was Shirley Temple.
Oh, my word.
When my father lived in Chaffee, before my mother moved down, he would come to St. Louis, 125 miles away, to be with the family every other week. And every Sunday, he would attend different church services. Small town, they had about a dozen churches there. To show his sense of ecumenicism, of togetherness, and I think people respected him so.
Thank you.